thank you for coming out tonight. It's really good to be back at the Falcon. I feel very lucky to have been around the Falcon room and the Falcos and the whole crew for quite some time. Going back to the old Falcon. I was thinking about this today, actually. I think the first time I played kind of solo in public was actually at the old Falcon. It wasn't even a set of solo guitars with Taylor Axton. And we didn't have, I don't know, maybe had like 35 minutes of music that we knew. We had to fill an hour. So I was like, dude, God, that solo. I was like, not my thing. He said, come on, anything you can think of. And I just learned that Charlie Chaplin song, Smile. It's one of the best songs of all time. It's okay, I'll do it. I'll do it on there. Yeah. And it was on YouTube, and I saw it, and for years I avoided solo, but I look at that video and go, that's proof of concept, I can do it. I did it once, I did it at the Falcon, it can be done. So there's something sweet about returning all these years later to do a full set of it. We're on tour right now, doing this, and you know, years ago a friend of mine dared me to do a project that kind of scared me, and it would have been many years after that performance with Taylor. And I said, well, let's make a solo guitar record. I said, okay, let's do it. Here's the money. Go do it. And I immediately regretted it. Let's say that. Something so vulnerable about it. So we made a record, went down to North Carolina, we recorded, I wrote some music, and we ended up scrapping the whole record that's never been heard. And for a good, for a good reason. It was, I sound terrified. And I had this kind of notion that it was like a one-man band, and, you know, wear the symbol on the head. No, but you know what I mean? It was like I really was trying to cover all the bases. And I heard it, and I thought, man, what's so cool about the guitar to me is the vulnerability of it, the stuff I take for granted when I'm at home playing by myself. Any guitar player here knows that. You know, it's beautiful. It's very intimate. So we re-tracked the record, and I rewrote most of the music. And it became an album called World's Fair. It came out.
So yeah.
The first two songs I played for you tonight are from that record. The first one is called Gardens. And the second one, that last number, is called Day and Age. I'd like to continue now with a song by the great Ornette Coleman. Something from his album Virgin Beauty, which is a tremendous record. They all are. But this song in particular was always very meaningful to me. It's called Chanting. Thank you all so much. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. tonight.
Thank you.
That's a tune of mine called Northern Shuffle. It's from a new record. We just made a trio plus three record, so sextet album that, God willing, that'll be out in the new year. And it's kind of it's a record of spirituals, you know, tunes that we wrote, but I think of it as kind of an avant-garde gospel record in a lot of respects. And that song is part of that. It's kind of the touchstone of that book of music. Blending these worlds. Before that, I played you one of my favorite older tunes. I'm Getting Sentimental Over You, one of the great ones, truly, truly great ones. And before that was that Ornette tune we were talking about. A few records back, we made an album called Squint, and it's a trio record, electric guitar, bass, drums, trio record. And the whole thought process was to make a swing record, and a swing record for, kind of dedicated to my heroes, people like Billy Higgins, Wilbur Ware, Doug Watkins, Dewey, Don Cherry, all these cats, I played with Billy Higgins when I was a kid. Messed me up. I haven't been the same since. You don't know Billy, I think you think he's still the most recorded drummer of all time, but certainly the greatest jazz drummer in my assessment. But nonetheless, I wrote all this music, right, out of love, just dedication to these players, and this one piece kind of emerged, and it sounds nothing like the music they played, but in many respects, I think it honors their sense of orchestration, or their sense of elegance, frankly, they're incredibly elegant players. And it's called Etude. It's basically a solo classical guitar piece, but it's part of this bigger jazz oeuvre. Anyway, I'd like to play that for you now. And that'll take us into another number from a more recent record called Auditorium. Thank you all very much for being here. I'm so glad to play. Yeah.
Thank you.
one more song. That last number, that was two songs in one. That was a blues by Charles Lloyd called Island Blues. And what led into that is a song called Hymnal from that record I was telling you about. It's been such a pleasure to play here again after so many years, and just my deepest heartfelt gratitude to the family, Lee and Julie and everybody, and just the staff and all of you for coming and supporting live music, which it's my understanding is the whole premise of this spot. And Tony's dream, someone I love very dearly. So thank you all for being here. I want to acknowledge before I play the last song my man doing sound tonight and also every single night for me, and it makes all of our records and engineers them and makes them a true master, Mr. Mark Goodell. Please give him a round of applause. I'll leave you with a song that I wrote for that World's Fair record, and it's for my partner in crime so often is Mr. Jorge Rutter, incredible bassist, composer, arranger, and just total madman. This is dedicated to him. It's named after where he grew up in Peru. So I'll leave you with Peru. Thanks, everybody. Good night.
Yeah. Talked us into it.
Thank you, everybody. It's been a pleasure.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Yeah.